And welcome back. And we have the amazing Dr. Betty Martini, who's a great warrior against toxic sweeteners. On the second segment, we're going to bring on Dr. Woodrow Monty, who's also a medical doctor who did a lot of research. I talked to him before the show today about the 11% of aspartame converts directly to methyl alcohol. And when methyl alcohol is metabolized, it converts directly in its first stage metabolic transform to formaldehyde. And, of course, it also contains the aspartame diketopiperazine, which is a fuel additive to red jet fuel, believe it or not. You don't need jet fuel in your body. Aspartame is an abortifacient, a neurotoxin, and a genotoxin. So, Dr. Betty, this article that you got me, you sent to me today, is one of the most shocking I've ever seen. And the move is on, I think, in Europe to actually outlaw aspartame, isn't there?
Yes, and it started with a study by Dr. Eric Millstone. And when I lectured in England and Scotland, I happened to meet him. He's a scientist who has been exposing aspartame and researching for like 30 years. And he's done a study that's called European Food Safety Authority's Toxicological Assessment of Aspartame. Was it even-handedly trying to identify possible unreliable positives and unreliable negatives? And basically, it goes through the original studies and how bad they were. When you talk about proving safety, what aspartame actually proved was horrible birth defects, and they sealed the studies. And aspartame breaks down to a brain tumor agent called diketopiperazine and caused brain cancer. That's what they found. Also, grand mal seizures. And they were trying to get together the pivotal studies. Those are the best you have for approval. And they couldn't even get studies that showed safety. One of those was a 52-week oral toxicity study that was done on 7 infant monkeys. 5 had grand mal seizures and 1 died. They used that as pivotal in the approval of aspartame. So it also showed all these different neurological problems. And interestingly, also with the testes, and I was talking to an oncologist who said that testicular cancer is absolutely rampant, he said, with the brain tumors. So this is, and both U.S. prosecutors went to work for the defense team. So if they wanted to indict them and they couldn't prove safety, and that their own FDA list has 92 symptoms, including death, then how could anyone say that they were safe? But interestingly to all this is that Jana Marie Kincaid got in touch with me, and she was hired by Searle to shred the studies and send one copy to France. And her father is a physician, and she'd been with him in studies, and she knew what she was looking at, and she said that aspartame killed everything it touched. And as soon as it was put on the market, there was such an outcry that the FDA couldn't even take the complaints and was forwarding them to the AIDS hotline. So we've known this all these years, and many doctors and myself have tried to get it banned, and we have a new FDA that came under the old FDA that's no longer there that tried to stop the approval.
Right.
So it's, yeah, so now with this new study, it's making breaking news all over the world. I just gather up the articles during the day. Because it's, you know, you've had all these new studies showing cancer and strokes and myocardial infarction and raising fasting blood sugar. And these things, these kind of things that we sent to the European Food Safety Authority back in 2013, and that's what he's talking about. All these studies that were available at the time that showed how deadly aspartame is were rejected by the European Food Safety Authority.
Right.
And Mark Goad of the Aspartame Toxicity Center did have them reported to a anti-fraud institution, because what they did is they took a review by industry and plagiarized it and left out all the studies that were so damning, like the Croco study, which shows the formaldehyde embalms living tissue and damages DNA. So what aspartame has shown is how deadly a product can be. And so Dr. Millstone has gone through them all and exposed it.
What's amazing to me is that how many years it's taken, how many specialists have come forward. Like last week, Dr. Woodrow Monti, and last week we had Dr. Ralph Walton, yourself and many others, myself, literally campaigning against this for almost 15 years now. And you're doing it for, like, I think around 28. You've been at this for a long time.
Yeah,
the, we call it Rumsfeld disease, because Rumsfeld uses markers to get it through. Even though they knew it was toxic, they managed to shove this through and bypass the proper standards for testing that would indicate it's this toxic. And if you look at the history of aspartame, it was a chemical that was actually originated by the Nazi Germans as a abortifacient and as a toxic lethal agent that could kill. And people need to understand that in these death camps, if a woman got pregnant, they would actually abort them. And, of course, this drug is an abortifacient, too. It'll prevent pregnancies. It also causes brain damage. It causes many other illnesses, including cancer, ADD, ADHD, depression, many other problems, too, doesn't it? Please continue.
Well, not only that, but then when you talk about ADD, the ADD people were interviewed, and they said before aspartame was put on the market, they hardly even used the term. So now our children are medicated instead of educated, but it's worse than that, because with ADD, they give them a prescription for Ritalin.
Well, Ritalin or one of these other drugs that affects the reticular activating system. And by the way, the children that go off Ritalin become criminals. The rate of criminal behavior after the discontinuation from Ritalin is very high.
Yes, but the big problem is that when they get a prescription filled, they get the generic. And with full knowledge, they put aspartame in Ritalin. So they have no chance of getting well at all. And they're doing it in a great many generic drugs. And so that's the reason when we have childhood obesity that's caused from aspartame. They've just done a brand new study in Canada in the last few weeks on it. So its effect is a whole generation, and all these epidemics are being noticed around the world, like MS and lupus and the brain tumors, and people are going blind from the methanol. And while all this is happening, here you have the agencies, and I'm glad that Dr. Millstone went after it, EFSA, because we did our best to get them to be credible and show what really had gone on. And to show you how bad they are, back when the Ramazzini studies were done on cancer, the industry didn't want them to accept those particular studies. And the head of the committee, Dr. Herman Coder, actually resigned, and in a press release said, "We were pressured by industry to hijack science." So EFSA went along with industry, and now it's been proven from the very beginning, aspartame not only was not proven safe, but showed to be a dangerous chemical poison.
What's amazing to me, and this is like the tip of the spear, I did a lecture about 12 years ago called The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly with the American Academy of Anti-Aging Medicine. And I included aspartame up there with depleted uranium exposure and exposure to toxic genetically modified foods. And again, there's co-toxicity with other things, GMO foods and scalar radiation from cell phones, Wi-Fi networks, and so on. But aspartame by itself, Advantame, which is a new version of aspartame, Splenda, which is basically an optical isomer of sugar that's chlorinated, so it releases chlorine inside your DNA and forms DNA adducts and what's called thymidine dimerization to attach and cross links in your DNA, which will cause DNA breaks. People understand that we have enzymes to try to repair that, which is to repair DNA breaks, but it can't fix these kind of breaks. So the result, you get micronuclei outside your nuclei. These are a marker of cancer. You end up with DNA breaks, so you end up with loss of control of your DNA and oncogenes. So oncogenes get activated, which are sitting in your DNA. It's like bad books in your library that if you read them, you get cancer. And these are ancient virus DNA. To be honest, most people don't realize that 93% of human DNA is ancient viral DNA assembled in such a way to create a library of books or letters that actually create all the books to create all the organs of your body, including your heart and your brain and your eyeballs. But if you miscontrol them, you can release cancer and autoimmune disease and autoallergy. For example, aspartame is an adjuvant, so it'll attach to body proteins and make them more immunogenic to produce an autoimmune reaction, whether it's autoimmune thyroid disease or other disorders, and also causes the cells to weaken so they can't fight against stealth pathogens, so they're going to get genetic changes that cause the cell to try to escape, which is called cancer. Cancer is an escape phenomena from chronic stress, usually toxins like aspartame, and stealth pathogens. People don't realize that no disease is without stealth pathogens in the presence of toxins like aspartame. Right?
Yes. I'd like to say a few words about Dr. Monty, since he is going to
He'll be on the next segment in about, well, we'll be finished another 4 minutes for this segment, but he'll be coming on segment two, so we'll have lots of discussion.
Okay, I'd like to tell you that he is a hero of...
2 minutes, 30 seconds. Go ahead.
Okay, that he's really a hero. He has taken the issue of aspartame all the way to the Supreme Court, who wouldn't hear it, and he exposed it to such an extent that his house was blown up with him in it. And
oh, really?
he lived in Arizona in this hot climate, and he knew that aspartame breaks down at moderate temperature or 86 degrees. So you can imagine if you put Diet Pop in front of a 7-Eleven, you've got formaldehyde cocktails. So he tried to get a meeting to try to get it banned in Arizona, and they kept turning it down, and they would send lobbyists, and finally he got the meeting, and what they did was they took a bill that had already passed that had to do with toxic waste, and they removed the guts of it and deregulated aspartame to prevent the meeting, because anytime there was a meeting, then it would be very obvious what a deadly poison it is. They sealed the teratology studies, and when we were able to find them after 8 years, Dr. Monty went on and wrote this book, While Science Sleeps, The Sweetener Kills.
Right.
So he really is an authority on it, and he calls aspartame a killing machine, and you will enjoy talking with him. But I wanted people to know just how much this hero has done from the very beginning.
That's amazing, yeah. And, of course, his website is whilesciencesleeps.com. He makes it spellable and rememberable, whilesciencesleeps.com. Amazing, and of course, I want people to understand this battle is soon going to be over, because once the Europeans allow the lawsuits against it, it will collapse just like the collapse against Roundup here in America, where Bayer Pharmaceutical, the maker of the Zyklon B in the death camps in Nazi Germany that took over Mount Satan, are called Monsanto, for genetically modified foods. The company Ajinomoto, Japan, took over manufacturing from America and Japan. And they spread this toxin around the world. It's destroying lives, genetics, fertility, and causing cancer and premature death, seizure disorders, suicide, and much more. Blindness. We'll be back in a moment with more about toxic sweeteners and the sweet misery it causes with Dr. Woodrow Monty, while ScienceSleeps.com is his website.
Do you have difficulty taking supplements? Are you searching for a high-quality, complete nutritional drink that your whole family will love? NutraMedical's Life Support has arrived. All of your daily nutritional requirements in one quick, delicious drink. Dr. Bill Deagle's Life Support is a proprietary blend of vegan protein, activated vitamins, essential minerals, amino acids, probiotics, green tea, digestive enzymes, anti-inflammatories, cancer prevention, detoxification, and much more. Your body will high-five you for this one. Life Support is the best complete nutrition meal replacement on the market. Whether you are an elite athlete, have post-operative challenges, chronic illness, elderly, or a family that just wants a quick, delicious drink, try Dr. Bill Deagle's Life Support for optimized nutrition in one great-tasting smoothie. Just add cold water, almond milk, fruit, or anything else you like. NutraMedical's Life Support. Try our great-tasting chocolate or vanilla today. Call 888-212-8871 or visit us online at NutraMedical.com. NutraMedical.com for the whole family.
Legacy Emergency Foods is the top recommendation from Dr. Bill Deagle for the lowest oxygen concentration, the largest entrees, the highest amount of protein, the most varied entrees as well, and the longest food storage life. Nothing like Legacy Emergency Foods, and if you place a regular monthly order, you get 20% off and free shipping. Do get emergency foods for your supply for preparation and get it from Legacy Foods. Contact Dr. Bill Deagle for the link at NutraMedical.com. Go to the Shop by Products link and drop down message at NutraMedical.com and then place your orders for regular emergency food for yourself and your family. Nothing like emergency food if the power goes out and you can't go to grocery stores or if there's an emergency or a national crisis. So NutraMedical.com, top recommendation, Legacy Foods. NutraMedical.com, go to the Shop by Products and drop down menu and stay well with NutraMedical every day of your life. Lumen Photon Therapy, infrared light, far and near infrared, is extremely important for pain control, stimulation of nitric oxide, improved perfusion, and stem cell activation and reduction of cytokines. Dr. Bill uses it for pain control, for regeneration techniques, for organ regeneration, and for stimulation of your stem cell activity. This is amazing. Lumen Photon Therapy this year will probably have an additional device with frequency therapy during the on phase of the lights. To obtain a Lumen Photon machine, contact Dr. Bill at NutraMedical.com, 888-212-8871. He'll prescribe it with you, providing nutraceuticals to help with your regeneration, healing, and pain control. Nothing like the Lumen Photon Therapy for easy therapy for your eyes, your pain, your joints, regeneration of organs, detoxification of the body. Get a Lumen Photon machine from Dr. Bill Deagle, NutraMedical.com, 888-212-8871. To stay well with NutraMedical. The Sonic Life Machine is one of the most amazing therapies that Dr. Bell provides. It is the best sine wave exercise machine on the planet, doing whole body vibration, opening up the muscle to reduce insulin resistance, improve perfusion, release stem cell therapies throughout the body, and epigenetically stimulate the body to release DNA activated. The epigenetic therapy with the sine wave curve of frequencies given for atomic resonance, but Linus Pauling for minerals and amino acids, stimulates the production of messenger RNA to correct structural protein enzyme deficiency for almost every illness. There's nothing like the sine wave therapy for improving body healing for exercise, but also the epigenetic treatments Dr. Bell can provide can help neutralize frequencies for disease states and illness. Get a Sonic Life machine through Dr. Bill Deagle at NutraMedical.com. Contact us at NutraMedical.com, 888-212-8871, or go to the website NutraMedical and give us a contact. Dr. Bill is available to help you get well with NutraMedical.
Need a powerful ally to fight daily bugs and serious pathogens? Allicin Med is the powerful universal pathogen killer's latest advance of German-sourced allicin, enzymatically stabilized to clear the body of bacteria, fungi, mycobacteria, and parasites. It penetrates body biofilms and is non-toxic to tissues. Pathogen resistance cannot develop for long-term body-optimized wellness. Clear stealth pathogens that promote autoimmune disease, cancer, and vascular inflammation and plaque and promote healing of tissues. Now pathogen-free. With 200 milligrams more power than prior Alamed, you can't get a more powerful ally to fight daily bugs and serious pathogens. Give your body what it needs. Allicin Med. Order Dr. Bill Deagle's Nutridyne at 888-212-8871 or NutraMedical.com. That's 1-888-212-8871 or NutraMedical.com. And listen to the NutraMedical Report on the Genesis Radio Network with open lines every weekday. NutraMedical.com, bringing nutrition and medicine together.
And welcome back. And we have joining us with Dr. Betty Martini, Dr. Woodrow Monty, who's a hero, who has been doing a lot of research. And, of course, this is a pretty straightforward conversion of aspartame to methyl alcohol, and methyl alcohol deferred in its first step of conversion to formaldehyde. So, Dr. Monty, I really appreciate all you coming on the program to give us information. We'll probably get on about more regularly. Tell us what your journey and how close we are to getting it banned, perhaps in Europe and then eventually in America and worldwide, this very toxic, dangerous sweetener.
Well, I don't think we've really gotten very far at all because it's, we've been trying for over 35 years to remove this stuff from the marketplace because,
right.
It does produce a terrible toxin. And, the more scientists look back at people who consumed aspartame, especially for fairly long periods of time, I mean, they're seeing connections to heart disease. They're seeing connections to Alzheimer's. They're seeing connections. They're seeing all sorts of connections that were fairly predictable, early on. And so even initially in the work done, of course, by the Food and Drug Administration,
right.
They didn't want it in the public purview either. So, it's it can't be done until somebody puts their foot down. Someone says, hey, look, we've got to stop this. But in the meantime, people can listen to what we have to say and at least make their own decisions. But it's very difficult to stay away from aspartame right now because it is the cheapest, because it's lost its patent a long time ago. And so it's the cheapest way to sweeten foods. And so people are using it for that purpose.
Right.
Because it's so inexpensive. And so that makes it a terrible problem. So the consumption basically has been going up and going up and going up consistently. For all these years. And there's been, so you ask how we're doing. I don't think we're doing very well.
Yeah, do you think we need a change in strategy? What would you, a strategy change? Let's talk about this later. But I want to get into the biochemistry and what you've done in your research and what you presented. Again, this article that Dr. Betty sent me sounds to me like we're very likely to see some major, at least investigations in Europe, because Europeans are much more open to the idea of looking at toxic things like genetically modified foods. In some places, like in Paris, it's against the law to actually make bread, the type of baguette bread, with more than just four basic ingredients and nothing genetically modified. We're seeing a kind of a move toward the idea in the public, at least public information, even if the regulators are not on side yet, that the public's becoming more aware that there's things in their food that aren't good.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, and I think this recent article that was done by an English professor who looked into how the European Food Safety Authority, how they were just the group that looked into aspartame to determine whether it was safe, was basically planted with industry prostitutes who were willing to do anything and say anything to get it approved. And so this finally that truth has come out. Because once the Food Safety Authority of Europe, of the European Union, came out with that carte blanche saying, no, it's okay, people thought, these people, like you said, Europe is so careful. But it was a very special case, and it was treated very specially, and a tremendous amount of money went into that to get it approved. And finally, they've looked at the way they did it, and they've brought out the serious, serious faults in the, right. in the way it was looked at and how prejudicial it was. But still, if you call the European Food Safety Authority, they'll still say it's safe. I mean, they'll just base everything on that the original decision. But this article did a beautiful job of exposing it for what it was. So hopefully that helps.
Yeah. It's my feeling that we need to have much more pro-state litigation action by individuals because the Bar Association, the lawyers, and the politicians who are often corrupt aren't going to help. It's obvious that 30 years of experts like yourself and Dr. Martini, Dr. Woodrow Monty, yourself, and Dr. Dr. Ralph Walton and many others coming forward isn't sufficient. Dr. Betty mentioned that your house was blown up. Do you think it was actually an action by these people against you because you were actually coming out against aspartame?
It was a long time ago, and it was a very suspicious fire. The police found places where people they thought were hiding in the bushes and blah, blah.
Really?
There's a lot of suspicion around it, but it was just, you know.
Never proven, but in other words, a lot of circumstances
never
that didn't look.
I think it was. I mean, it was just, you know, I mean, they're vicious. They're evil group of people from the ground up. I mean, you know, it started off with G.D. Searle and Company and Donald Rumsfeld, and then, you know, then Monsanto bought it out. And what could be worse than Monsanto? And then
I changed their name to Mount
Monsanto,
Satan.
And they sold it. So, and now there's no patent on it, so anybody can make it. Ajinomoto is the major manufacturer in the world right now, the manufacturer of.
One of the discussions that we had last week with Dr. Ralph Woodrow Walton was the idea that that beyond greed and just perversion and corruption, there's an evil here that transcends common sense and decency. And he found it difficult, being a psychiatrist, to label it evil. I don't have difficulty with seeing an evil here, because if you just look at this at a very basic level, even just basic chemistry, you have to realize this is not going to be good for health. Anything can convert to methyl alcohol, which even the still guys that run stills in the Appalachian Mountains know. You got to pour off the first liquor that has methanol because it'll make you blind. And in fact, this is what's happening with aspartame. It encourages blindness, brain damage, neuropathy, and cancer, and many other conditions. And if you just look at the stuff.
Birth defects. Don't forget birth defects.
Yeah, that's birth defects.
That makes me really angry, because that's what was really ignored, and that's what was hidden from me especially. Because I did work with rats. And I showed that these animals, you know, in them it led to birth defects, odd behavioral problems, neural tube defects, you know, and this is in the literature. And then we found out that the government actually had that information before we even did the work, and it never let it out. And we're dealing with, you know, a situation where, I mean, Ralph and I think that there's definitely an association between methanol aspartame consumption and autism, because we did a study ourselves.
Well,
you know,
break down the blood-brain barrier and neurotransmitter levels in myelinations. You can see patchy dysmyelination on T1-weighted MRI or quantitative EEG. You can see abnormal voltages and coherence patterns, unmatching the coherence patterns of the cortex, too.
Well, it's terrible. Exactly. I mean, it's a brain problem, a situation, because it's a very complicated thing with humans. Humans are more sensitive to methyl alcohol than any other animal. No, you can't find a good animal model for methanol poisoning. That's the thing that's been holding us back.
You know,
it was at the turn of the 1800s to the 1900s, the turn of that century, that, you know, all the animal work that was done showed that methanol was safer than ethyl alcohol.
Okay,
so they started putting methanol as a replacement for ethanol in cough medicine and vanilla, you know, extract, that kind of thing. And people were dying right and left. I mean, at the first and last time in history, in 1905, that the American Medical Association finally came out, and they came out against methanol. You know, they had an expert group they put together, and they said, no, we want the Food and Drug – well, they didn't have a Food and Drug Administration then. We want the government to ban methanol in any food.
Right.
You know, even before they had evidence that it was safe, because they couldn't test it. They couldn't test it in animals. And so this is the magic of the whole thing. I mean, it has a history. It has an exciting history. I'm an older guy. I'm sort of retired from the university. I'm hoping that some young researchers will get excited about what methanol does, you know, and what damage it does to the human body. Because in nature, it's hard to find pure methanol. It's very difficult, only in processed foods and in aspartame.
Well, let me mention a little study that I did, because I have a background in immunotoxicology. And my studies go back 40 years. I work with UCLA with Dr. Chung and Vujidani on trimethylglycerol and trimethyltrichinhydride, which is, of course, from diesel fuel, toluene diisocyanate, and formaldehyde. And we actually measured HSA, or human serum albumin, antibodies. Now, it turns out you can measure an HSA antibody against formaldehyde also. I asked Dr. Vujdani a year and a half ago when I was giving a lecture at the Academy of Anti-Aging Medicine in Las Vegas on my research in anti-aging, and he mentioned it could be done. But I have another doctor, Dr. William Shaw, who used to be the CDC director, Center for Disease Control, and he runs Great Plains Laboratory, and I'm going to see if he can do it or one of my other colleagues. But I want to get a specific aspartame antibody test. Now, we have the formaldehyde antibody regime was set up over 39 years ago at UCLA with Dr. Chung and Fujidani. And what we've noticed is, because I was noticing people that were out-of-body workers got exposed to toluene diisocyanate, fast-drying paints, and they ended up with cardiac conduction problems, autoimmune disease, blindness, cancer, dementia, etc. And it's a very similar thing. I believe we can measure a titer against aspartame or its congeners like formaldehyde or methanol. And we should be able to measure those against human serum albumin because when they attach to a body protein, they increase the immunogenicity of it, which means your body can start attacking that protein and get autoimmune disease. And actually, when you get enough inflammation and cytokines, you can get an escape phenomenon we call cancer. And cancer is an escape phenomenon. And so it's my feeling that we should be able to measure titers of people that are aspartame drinkers. And not only measuring things like formaldehyde or metabolites in their urine or fatty tissues, and we should be able to measure their DNA adducts because, for example, all these things are DNA adducts. We should measure 8-hydroxy-2-prime-deoxyguanosine as a DNA adduct of pyrimidines and oxidized fatty acids because a lot of diseases, including diabetes, are triggered by oxidative damage. And, of course, I believe that this is a major oxidant stress on the body, which triggers off diabetes and vascular disease and cancer. And there's a common pathway here, isn't there?
Oh, definitely. Oh, definitely. Well, I mean, the problem you're going to have with methanol, it's the smallest, you know, it's the smallest alcohol. It's got one carbon.
Right.
The stuff within minutes, if a pregnant woman takes a sip of diet soda, there's methanol, within 20 minutes, there's methanol in the brain of her fetus.
Ooh.
That's how quickly it moves. And then, on top of that, very few cells in the body can actually metabolize the methanol to formaldehyde. And this just makes it, again, different than any animal, okay?
Right.
Our human catalase, does not metabolize. Methanol.
Wow.
And so this makes it really difficult, but really, really, really important because that methanol is being turned into formaldehyde in the linings of the vessels in places like the brain.
Right.
That's where it's happening. And that formaldehyde is not going to travel very far. It's going to go maybe a centimeter into the brain, and then it's going to attach itself to a protein because that's the way formaldehyde does.
And it's very reactive. Yeah,
it's very reactive, but it's, you know, methanol is a much more efficient way to get formaldehyde into the brain than in pure formaldehyde because pure formaldehyde is so reactive, hardly any of it can get in the brain, even with a massive dose of formaldehyde in a living body. In a cadaver, you know, when the animal's dead, the formaldehyde passes all the way through the body, and that's how you do.
Yeah, amazing. Keep those thoughts. We'll be right back with the next segment with Dr. Woodrow Monty and Dr. Betty Martini. This is scary stuff, but it's reality, and we need to start changing our strategies. Like, as I say, the bug theory: if you don't believe in glass, you're not going to get through the window because you keep bumping your nose. We need to change our strategy so we can win against this toxic poison and abortifacient genotoxin, etc., with amazing research from Dr. Woodrow Monty.
Are you still looking for that one iodine that you can really trust? A medical doctor-endorsed product that is backed by honest research and true integrative science? Then search no further. Go to NutraMedical.com for Dr. Bill Deagle's Nutriodine, proven time and time again to be the very best iodine available for you. Nutriodine is the only Tesla-activated monatomic plasma iodine in the world. It optimizes mitochondrial function and generation of new mitochondria from totally neutralizing the venom from a desert recluse spider bite in Southern California to eliminating malaria parasites reported by medical missionaries in Central India. Dr. Bill's Nutriodine is simply the most powerful healing formula there is. Nutriodine clears the body of all known pathogens, restores it to an alkaline state, and even promotes stem cell regeneration. Order Dr. Bill's Nutriodine today at 888-212-8871 or visit us online at NutriMedical.com.
Red Deer Velvet DR is an amazing new product with a patent to preserve 300 biomolecules and 6 hormones, same as fetal life, where you don't age at all. The state of fetal life allows the 300 biomolecules and 6 hormones produced by the placenta to be supportive of the regeneration of tissues and organs, with maximum apoptosis changing the tissue and organ structure of a fetus. That's why if fetal surgery is performed, there is no scar. Taking 2 to 3 capsules twice a day with oncomycin, myco-D2, provides an amazing support for regeneration of any tissue and organ in the body, and even advanced stem cell therapy support treatment. Do get NutriMedical's Red Deer Velvet DR from Dr. Bill Deagle at NutriMedical.com, NUTRIMedical.com, 888-212-8871. Stay well and stay young with NutriMedical.
Hi, I'm Dr. Bill Deagle, MD, AAEM, ACAM, A4M, of NutriMedical.com, and a consultant providing email advice free on advanced protocols for your optimized wellness and advanced technologies to heal and regenerate you. You can contact us at NutriMedical.com, that's NutriMedical.com, or 888-212-8871. You get free email starter protocols of our top medical-grade nutraceuticals, initial testing, and recommendations for your own primary doctor to do, as well as recommendations to give you an idea of a consultation and a full protocol to try to help you regenerate your tissues, heal naturally without the use of toxic polypharmacy. I can send test kits to you as well anywhere in the world and provide you recommendations for referral of specialty clinics worldwide. So contact me, Dr. Bill Deagle, at NutriMedical.com. That's NutriMedical.com or 888-212-8871.
At NutriMedical.com, we have the most amazing drinks with the best mouthfeel, highest quality bio-nutrient exposure to your body to heal and regenerate, and the most powerful persistence of nutrients to heal your body dramatically. We have Ageless, which makes you age less, which repairs your DNA, extends your telomeres, etc. We have Life Support that detoxes phase 2 detox pathways, glucuronidation, sulfation, and methylation pathway support. We have Glycemics that blocks the carbohydrate absorption and helps with diabetes or weight loss, and as well helps with people that are trying to build up muscle, using things like our special formulas from Dr. Wolf called Mega Muscles between meals along with Sports Energy Light. We have the amazing NutriComplete, the most complete red and greens drink in the world, with the best mouthfeel and flavor. You can often mix it, too, with Vitamin Mineral Mix, which is our fruit-flavored mixed power of vitamins. Stay well with NutriMedical every day.
I remember when I lost my mind.
And welcome back. And Dr. Monty and Dr. Betty Martin, Dr. Monty, please continue, because, you know, I have some ideas on strategy. If what we did before didn't work, obviously, we need to start doing more talks at medical schools. We also need to start taking pro se litigant action and bypass the attorneys and the judges. We need to actually start suing not only the politicians that are corrupt that are involved with this, people like Mr. Rumsfeld, but also we need to sue the drug companies themselves that actually put these things out and the bottling companies that actually put it out, like, you know, Pepsi-Cola, Coca-Cola, and others that use this, or even the pharmaceutical companies that include in chewable vitamins, almost like vitamins, chewable flavored drugs, for example, like children that are taking drugs for ADD, ADHD. And I think that there's, if the public actually decided to take up the wand of doing this instead of looking at the lawyers, because the lawyers are going to protect industry. They don't want to lose their law degree or get sanctioned by their judges and so on for coming up against big industry. And I don't think you need to spend a lot of money to do this. Our courses, you can get it at a drop-down menu, diagnostic and therapeutic. You can, we're going to have him back on the program to design this course on how to win in court. I think the problem I see is that we rely on the politicians who are basically either dumb or they're so corrupt they're not going to take action, or whatever actions they take against government agencies is ineffective. We need to sue not only the agencies but individuals inside the agencies and even their public statements they make supporting aspartame, don't we?
Definitely.
Yeah. So whatever we did in the past, I don't know what's going to work, but I have some menu of things that could work that we should try. And it's not just dealing with aspartame. It's genetically modified food that maintains, they'd say, tomatoes with scorpion genes, or recycling toxic water that contains toxic material. They call it toilet to tap water. How about industrial waste to your genes water? You know, to me, it's kind of crazy what we're doing. We're 327 million guinea pigs here, aren't we? And, of course, it's all around the world now, so it's billions of guinea pigs to these toxic materials, and their co-toxicity with other things like scalar radiation from cell phones, Wi-Fi networks, mineral-depleted soils, etc. The human race is really in an extinction-level event from what I can see.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's a good point. It's a good point, but I mean, what I find is so fascinating, though, about this particular topic was methanol, and that is, as I said, you know, every other animal in the world has catalase enzyme in every cell of their body, and every cell has got a peroxisome, you know, or hundreds of peroxisomes. And peroxisomes are loaded with catalase, and their catalase enzyme can take methanol and take it all the way through with a little bit of peroxide. It can take it all the way through the carbon dioxide and water vapor, where it's safe, and they're saved from the effects of the methyl alcohol. Human catalase does not function on methanol at all, and that's what makes this amazing phenomenon happen. That's why it takes such a small amount. I mean, just about every week you'll be reading an article. I think last week was in Mexico where, you know, 40 or 50 people died from methanol poisoning. You hear about it all the time. What you don't hear about is the really small amount of methanol it took to kill these people. And the horror that they went through in dying from that substance,
right.
It's a terrible way to die. But why? It doesn't happen in animals. It doesn't happen in animals. And the reason is because this genetic problem we have with our catalase. And it's fascinating. And why more people aren't interested, other scientists aren't interested, I've tried everything to convince people that this should be their lifetime study. I mean, but anyway.
Well, what we're doing is an aspect of integrative functional pathology. You see, when I went to medical school, they said, well, you're too smart, Deagle. You had a PhD in biochemistry before you went into medicine. You should be a pathologist. I said, I came into medicine to find the cause of diabetes, which, by the way, I'm going to publish this year my research and what I found, which is very dramatic. But the problem is that what you're doing is talking about integrative functional medicine. This is not alternative care. This should be integrated into all health care. For example, if you give a drug that can bioconvert to something or even photoactivate in your skin, or if you take a kind of an aspartame lace, kind of chewable, that can actually be toxic to someone with post-traumatic stress disorder or depression or ADHD, this is insane, isn't it?
It sure is insane. Like I say, it's now the cheapest way to sweeten anything.
Wow.
And so, and there you go. It's cheaper than sugar. I mean, it's cheaper than sugar. It's so powerful of a sweetening agent, and there's a very small amount of it. It's lost its patent. It's being produced by Ajinomoto, the same people that produce, you know, MSG, and it's being sold very inexpensively throughout the world, and they're just grabbing for it before they grab for sugar. And sometimes,
right.
You know, you don't even know it's in there.
Well, what other co-toxins do you think interact with aspartame? Because we have other spin-offs now. We've got Splenda, which is chlorinated optical isomer of sugar. We've got Adventame.
Mm-hmm.
We've got lots of different names for it, just like we have different names. But we also have other things that we're doing to our food supply. What other cotoxins are you concerned about that amplify the negative effect of aspartame?
Honestly, you know, I think that the methanol itself is so powerful and does such tremendous harm that I barely even have a chance to think about, you know, cotoxins. Because, I mean, it's, you know, when you know exactly what, and I'm so glad you're a biochemist because you're one of the few people that understand what I'm saying.
Right.
Talk about the metabolism. And so Bill, so what the situation is where, if catalase does not metabolize, then where is it getting converted into formaldehyde? And where it's getting converted into formaldehyde are the few places in the body where there's alcohol dehydrogenase.
Yeah, that's in the stomach wall lining has alcohol dehydrogenase.
Exactly.
In fact, men have double the enzyme of women, so by the way, men are more efficient at converting it because they have double the enzyme level per square centimeter of stomach lining.
Exactly, and that's why women have a more incidence of problems with aspartame because they are unable to detoxify the methanol, as well as men can detoxify the methanol in their lining of their stomach.
Yeah, alcohol dehydrogenase is the only thing that can actually get rid of methanol, right?
Well, in a bad kind of way.
Yeah, a bad kind of way, but it's still yeah. Yeah, exactly. It converts to formaldehyde, though, but then they have higher formaldehyde levels. We have one person that Dr. Betty mentioned a few weeks ago that was about to be embalmed in, I think, Puerto Rico. But there was so much formaldehyde leaking out of their skin from drinking the high amounts of aspartame, probably, 12-plus bottles a day of Diet Pop, that they didn't need to embalm them because they're already pre-embalmed by taking aspartame. It's amazing.
I don't believe in that. That's sort of bullshit.
I think it's hyperbole, to be honest with you. I have a feeling it's hyperbole, but you know, maybe it's a way of the undertaker saving on formaldehyde because the person was already dead and whatever else was going on with them, but... to be honest with you, I like the idea of hyperbole because it focuses on an idea that we're doing things to our bodies that don't make sense, and the regulators are getting away with murder. And whether they're just greedy, uninformed, or just plain evil, it doesn't matter to me what their motives are. Our regulators aren't under any purview. The politicians certainly don't stop them. The lawyers don't stop them. The judges don't stop them. You went before the Supreme Court. How come the Supreme Court didn't take action? Why?
They don't know enough. That's what they said to me. I mean, I got that far, and they just said, well, we're not scientists. We trust the Food and Drug Administration. They do all the science for us. And then they, of course,
no.
And that's it. Ignorance is always a defense of the politician. Yeah, we saw that in Miller's.
Even if you're a scientist and you show that there's an inconsistency in their science, that they didn't want to accept your evidence, which would, in a court of law should be sufficient to say raise an inquiry to say, how did Rumsfeld get this passed when we knew already it was a toxin? I mean, it's not something new. I've known about this for many, many years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's an example of how big government is always toxic for your health, isn't it?
That's about it. And, that's what happens.
And the latest thing that I hear about, which is the aspartame, is about vaccines. I think that vaccines are cotoxic with aspartame because if you're taking vaccines, it damages the blood-brain barrier. And formaldehyde destroys the blood-brain barrier as well, doesn't it?
Well, here's the thing. I mean, this is a fascinating thing, and that is people are always saying, well, they talk about vaccine causing autism and all this. And so I looked into that. I had to look into that in order to be able for Ralph and I to get our article done. We reviewed all that literature. And so the fascinating thing is you make a vaccine, most vaccines, by combining a foreign protein with formaldehyde or glutaraldehyde. Mostly it's formaldehyde.
Right.
And you do it at proprietary methods, very, very small amounts of formaldehyde at body temperature. The formaldehyde combines with the foreign protein and makes an entity that is basically bait for the macrophages, for the white blood cells.
Right.
And the white blood cells clear them from the body extremely quickly, and that's what starts the process of antibody production. And so that's why they do that. So imagine if you're producing this formaldehyde inside of the body, close to tissue, like in the brain. And what about then multiple sclerosis, the disease multiple sclerosis, which I think is associated with methanol? I mean, it's
I did research actually on MS at various hospitals around the country for over years. My first wife died of MS. So they asked me to do research at UCLA back 40 years ago on it. And what I know is that aspartame, these adjuvants are probably attaching to the proteins of Lyme or Lyme-like parasites, babesiosis or ehrlichiosis. And so stealth pathogens, when you formaldehydize them, they have cross-reacting antibodies because the peptides look identical to myelin-basic protein. Mm-hmm. One of the things that you're pointing out is when you create a vaccine with formaldehyde, maybe just drinking aspartame can literally make your body immunogenic against body proteins and cell types and trigger off disease like MS because you're creating a cross-reacting antibody against the myelin-basic protein.
Exactly right. Exactly right. Exactly right. Did Betty ever send you a copy of my chapter in my book on the chapter on multiple sclerosis?
I don't think so. She did. I'll get her to send it again and we'll make sure. Dr. Betty, you're still there?
Yeah, I'm here.
I'll get her to send a copy of the chapter and we'll, if you'd like, I'll get that posted up. I think people should go to your website, which is, again, WildScienceSleeps.com.
Exactly. Well, science. And that's the name of my book as well, WildScienceSleeps.com. And it's basically about aspartame.
You should have a little intro with a little voicing from the C.S. Lewis, the talk between a minor minion and Satan when they actually made aspartame.
Really?
I'll just do a little voicing for a second here. Dear Lord Satan, Rumsfeld, our minion here on Earth, is doing so well with getting the toxin, neurotoxin, genotoxin, and abortifacient and aspartame, which creates formaldehyde, and so wonderful how it creates diseases that will terminate the very aggravating human race. Honestly, people say, I won't be able to sleep tonight. Yeah. Let's put it this way. You may not believe in evil, but believe me, evil bites, and it can leave marks. How's that? Yeah, amazing. You've done some amazing work, Dr. Monty. We're going to have you back on the program to talk about more of this. Thank you,
anytime,
Dr. Martini, for the referral, and thank you for listening out there. Please do not have aspartame in your diet. Don't drink it. Don't chew tablets with it. Realize if you already have a health problem, believe me, it's going to get a lot worse. And if you want to formaldehyde your brain, this is the best way to do it. Again, it is a major abortifacient, neurotoxin, genotoxin, and there's no excuse for our regulators allowing this over the last 35 years. It's disgusting. Which is an example that our politicians are useless, our Supreme Court's useless, our attorneys are useless, but we aren't. Pro se litigant action and suing your regulators and your politicians, I think, needs to happen next. Hopefully Europe will clear it and will sue the companies that make it, including Ajinomoto in Japan.
This is most appropriate.